Hello, I'm Falagin. Today we are going to be wiping the floors with aliens. Hey, hi, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Xcom Longer Impossible. Today we are finally attacking the first base in South America. We are getting prepped. As you can see, we are bringing in the Dream Team and there is going to be a race of alien activity in South America by the end of the year. Unless, of course, we fuck it up completely and have wounded on this mission, because I really need to send the same team twice, so I don't really want to have anyone wounded in this one. That's not gonna be
thanks
easy.
Thanks to Dr. Vollen's research and some clever developments done in engineering, this skeleton key should allow you to breach the alien compound. We've only got one chance to make this work, though, so let's make sure we do it right.
Alrighty then, let's make sure we do it right. Because we only have one chance on this though, and then the next one right after that. And I'm going to skip the cutscene, we've seen it already.
So far we don't have visual confirmation on the hostiles. I wouldn't get too comfortable though, we're expecting heavy resistance. They're probably moving into position as we speak.
I had the luxury of just dashing Netmare right off the bat, because we are at the edge of the map there and everybody's going to be to the left, which is where I will send the battle scanner right off the bat, because I don't think I will have the luxury of coming in without the welcoming committee. I want to be prepped for them. And looks like we see two outsiders over there, and that means we can set up and watch them die. There is two outsiders visible, which means there is probably at least one more.
Okay.
I'm gonna get ready at the top of the stairs, and then next turn we will be setting up in position, and the turn after that we shall obliterate them. We will activate them with a sniper, and when they take position in the half cover on the opposite side of the room, I am going to toss a rocket over there, and we will shot them the fuck
out.
Because when life gives you lemon, shoot that bitch in the face. Okay, we are going to be fighting some Exalt. And floaters, I believe. Cyber discs. And sectoids. And also, I'm pretty sure... Oh, there, would not go anywhere. Actually, that's good, I can just set up myself more aggressively that way. And yeah, by the way, I will be probably, well, certainly cutting this episode, since I will not be recording it in one part, so might as well make sure that I cut out the parts when I'm reloading stuff for half an hour, and, you know. Okay, so now I will set up in position. I'm gonna put myself on Overwatch as possible. If, of course, the aliens will return, then we will be ready for them.
Moving out.
Спешу.
If they don't patrol back, then whatever, I'm just gonna wait. And set up myself better, of course. And there is no need for Netmare to be that far away anymore. It's a plane! It's a bird! No, it's Netmare. The marshmallow death of the alien kind.
Je reste en observation.
Okay, let's make sure we have the right weapons steadied. Everyone else can overwatch. And the outsiders decide to. Come on, little lava lamps. Come on, come back. I dare you. Come on. Come on! Well, oh yeah, yeah, something's happening. They are returning indeed, which means we are going to have at least one Overwatch firing against them. And they will be setting up in the full cover, I mean half cover, as advertised, and then I will destroy them. Even though there is three of them, not two. Come on, oh, one of them is a big one with lightning reflexes. And it ate all my overwatches. Well, doesn't matter. The only thing that worries me is that one guy that
decided to jump down. He may be a little problematic, but I will just deal with him when the time comes. First of all, what's with that? Free aiming's a little broken, but yeah, now we are good.
Bring in the pain.
Whoop. That's gonna make it a little, duck hunt. I am going to put Serene in cover, and I want to holo target the big guy first because he seems to be rather difficult to hit despite standing in the open and being about the size of my ex-wife's mom. Now this may be an in the zone if it clicks correctly. If not, then yeah, no crit. Too bad. Rapid fire. Oh, mini fallag, no! Okay, so this doesn't look so good anymore. Now we must at least make sure that I kill the big guy because he's the most dangerous one and the little ones can take care of themselves. The one on the left is gonna be, I hope, my priority if I have enough firepower because he's going for
resupply
a flank
against
me. And I don't like it one bit. Yeah, I can't really use this.
Good to go.
Alright, 93, yeah, let's take it. Damn it, still not enough. Come on, Zombrad, take them both down.
Enemy X-ray down.
That was a pretty obvious choice, and that's also good. Okay, two enemies down. Now I have a 20%, which I'm probably gonna take because I'm gonna just use a smoke grenade to make sure that everyone is safe. And I believe that this guy is gonna be overwatching. If not, he's gonna probably want to run away or hunker down. I don't think he's going to even shoot me at all. He has very little chances of actually doing anything useful. So I think he won't even try. And I would not go closer with Barbarian, because there is probably a lot of enemies waiting for us in the corridor. That's why this guy hid down there. So yeah, I'd rather not walk into a trap. The only traps I'm walking into is when I come back in the morning drunk and my wife asks, where have you been all this time? I always say, I was buying you flowers. And then she says, it's 3 in the morning, god damn it. I was playing chess all night. No, I'm kidding, nothing like that happens. I don't drink that much. And the outsider decides to run the hell away. Okay, he's gonna shoot now. No. Well, poop. Okay, so the only thing I can really do is to get Serene to see him. So that Marek can shoot maybe. It's not very likely. Yeah, we don't really have a shot against this guy.
Heading to that location.
Maybe. Yep. 53 is not that great, but let's take it. Why not? It's dealing no damage, but it's okay because that outsider would probably regenerate it anyway. So.
Well, it looks like we found where they've been taking the abductees, but that still doesn't explain what the purpose of all this is.
It's the fourth alien base we're assaulting, Valen. I think you had enough clues and time to find out what the purpose of all this is. Okay, looks like I was in position to actually move Barbarian there in the previous turn. Well, I didn't know.
Mom is up one.
So yeah, we are going to move forward now carefully. I don't believe anything horrifying will happen. I think that the outsider is going to keep running away now and return in like 2-3 turns, so there isn't all that much we can do. As he is right now, then we simply have no way of effectively fighting him or chasing him. So I'm going to just try to cut his way.
Let's go.
Come on. Well, looks like the alien turn is really taking a while, so this may be a very interesting turn of the event. There may be more than 50 aliens in this base. That would be nice. And this is, by the way, one of my chances to capture the Imperial Commander. Oh, there you are. Two drones and seekers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Okay, so we are going to shoot them up and then we are going to basically wait. Am I going to use a rocket? I don't think this situation calls for a rocket. As much as a rocket would really, really help, I don't think this is gonna be necessary. It's only drones and seekers.
See you in hell.
We have a long battle ahead of us, so I don't really want to use consumables on bullshit. 6857, I'm gonna go for there. Boom, one seeker less to worry about, and now we can take care of the drone. Okay, the drone survived.
Need a resupply.
I can live with that. Now, Sombra needs to get here. He can finish the drone, or not. He can reload and shoot next turn, it is fine. Come on, Finn.
Boop. No longer a threat.
We should probably start thinking about the drone repair foundry project, because it's really useful against cyber disks and so on, so it may be nice to have it. Now, as for Serene, there is no better place for her to be. Just gonna hunker down, because I can't grapple in any good position. The outsider can double back and flanker, but it is too far to shoot, so I'm gonna just let it slide. Then let's wait for the seekers and drones to come out of stealth and do all that stupid things they do and then die. Come on. Don't be shy. The seekers are probably stealthed, so they will be jumping out of stealth and trying to strangle my people. I hope I have enough overwatches set up to stop them doing that. There is three seekers we are waiting for. And I see no evil. Okay, I see where this what is one of the seekers is by the dead tiles, but we are not going to act upon it because that is the campaign rule. No gamey mechanics. Cheese only on pizza.
Rolling.
Because it doesn't take good strategies for tactician to cheese the game.
Yes,
but
our
game. And see, that's where the one
on
is.
My way.
We are going to put Mutmara next to it. Because we are unaware of its presence.
Got
yes,
my eyes
yes,
on
yes,
it.
It happens here right
Roger
now.
Roger that. Scanning.
Bien, chef.
Okay. I'm actually gonna steady weapon here.
Overwatch.
Watching.
Mini Falag is going to dash because he can't move and overwatch anyway. And we don't know that he has a seeker right next to him. Because that would be cheese! So now we wait. And believe me that refusing the temptation to toss a grenade at that seeker was very tough for me. I think I actually hooked a little out of strain. But came down, all the same anyway.
Short.
One down, two to go. Come on, all right. Okay, one to go. And it is going to be somewhere. Where is it? Go, go, Bavarian. No. No. Well, I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going. Well, actually I haven't, but you know what I mean.
I'm about to start keeping score.
That's what she said.
It's killing time.
Okay, so I guess now we can slowly proceed forward. Must be careful because outsider.
Scanning.
Back in. Moving to Overwatch.
On y retourne.
Okay. All is well, I say.
I'm ready.
The outsider may return at any moment, he should be doubling back right about now, and Serin is going to unfortunately use one of our medkits. Well, shit happens. Come on. Oh, outsider. Wo bist du? Oh, there it comes. And damn it, that's not a very good start. I hope he's not gonna hurt anyone.
Enemy units retreating. Systems within acceptable
parameters. Well, poop. Luckily it's only armor damage, so we will live with that. I'm going to lead with Serin, and then we are going to try and do our best to kill this little fucker so we can proceed in peace. And now it is time for a rapid fire, or maybe suppression.
Come on. Okay.
Rapid fire would solve the situation for me if both shots would hit, but as it is, it's better for me to suppress this guy.
Back in.
And that way at least I'm certain that it is not going to do anything stupid, right? And we are dealing some damage. Okay, this looks very good now. We have single fin one.
Damn it.
And here we
Ready
are.
Now.
And I'm back, sorry for that guys, my phone called and I have stopped the recording for a while.
No
anyway,
threat.
The outsider is dead. The suppression turned out to not be really necessary. But you know, it is sometimes better to be safe than sorry later. And that's Xcom, so if we would not do this, then probably all the shots would miss and the outsider would be alive anyway. 3 days later we are going to go for the staircase. I'm going to leave a piece with me actually running, so you see what I'm doing when I'm cutting the past part of the episode.
Yes, sir.
As you see, we running like crazy.
Aye,
I know the area is secure, so I am wasting
Rock
no time
roll.
Just moving forward.
I'm on it.
And reloading on the way. I'm trying to do all those times at the things at the same time. Right now the area is relatively secure. And that means I can be moving fast. But right after this gate, we are out in the unknown uncharted seas and we are gonna hug the wall and then we are going to climb the middle of the staircase so that nothing horrible happens. Okay. Now, see, in order to not activate any enemies, we are going to have to hug the wall. See, that way we don't actually see the enemies that are down there and they can't see us. And then we are going to go millimeter by millimeter. Sneakily like ninjas. And then we are going to climb the staircase and set up in the proper positions so that the aliens can't see us. And we can't really see them, but we can hear them, which is important. So yeah, that's enough of the show of force. This, as you can imagine, took a while, but we are now ready on the case and I'm moving Faleg in position... fucking hell. Okay, we accidentally spotted a cyber disk down there, but it didn't see us. Yeah, it wasn't very safe, but it was the safest place I could move so that Falek could shoot from the next turn, and it may have been for the best. Now that they are activated in the opposite corner, everything is fine, but it was very dangerous and risky. It's not easy. Okay, now we can set up everybody else, and I want all the cyber disks suppressed and or disabled, because there may and probably are other aliens down there. Okay, it is time to begin. I'm going to have to cut the overwatchers with Serene first, as we expected. I don't know if it's something wrong with me, but I love the sound of cyberdisc cannon missing shots. It's just very satisfying sizzling. And as you see, we have a couple of exalt goons down there. I don't even know why they bother with ballistics, but you know. Okay, now we are going to suppress the big guy with Falag.
Don't lose your.
Now the overwatching small guy is gonna be suppressed by Brad, but first I'm gonna get Tiny in position. I'm gonna get Netmare in position. Netmare can shoot from here, but that's not very safe. Zuriel stays where she is.
Moving.
So now I have to control the battlefield with all those enemies down there. Some of them have grenades, and I also have to control the cyber discs in order to win this fight. Then I think I have just a way to do it. I'm gonna be keeping the cyber discs suppressed. I'm gonna use explosives to deny the exalt guy's cover. I'm gonna run and gun Bavarian to flank that guy on the left. That way he's not gonna go. Oh crap. Yeah, that's likely to kill him if it hits. If not, he's gonna have to go for a better cover. That's not the exact best thing that could possibly happen, but I guess we're gonna live with it. Now we want to disable the cyber disk. Next one, this one. Yes, this one is overwatching and I still have to move in position. So we have it controlled, and it's also easiest to hit. That nicely happened. And now this small flying cyber disk, when I find it, is going to be suppressed also. That way I don't have to worry about them. At least not so much. Now Singlefin is gonna have to make sure that the drone down there on the left is not going to go and attack the Bavarian. What the hell is wrong with that? Free target. Okay. And Trocket has to do two things. It must damage the drone on the left and break the cover so that exalt goons don't use it to go close to Bavarian. That basically gives me freedom in the left flank, which could very well end up in our death otherwise. Now Netmare has to get close. And we are going to I'm gonna shoot the big disc, I think, because it has to go down. Mini Fallen doesn't have unlimited ammo, despite what he may think. Okay, now we are going to use the MP. No, I can't really put it there. I can't put this, but I want to also hit the exalt guy. I'm gonna have to break some barrels of alien food. What the hell is wrong with that VA? God damn it. Yeah, I want to break those barrels of alien food so that the exalt fuckers have to go and find themselves on YouTuber. Preferably far, far away, and that will give me the time to deal with the cyber discs. Now, Zuriel, without moving, is going to toss two smoke grenades. One would have half action. Boom. Bridine. This is our protective roofie gas. By the way, we have learned from the secret files of Xcom in engineering that smoke grenades are actually made from ponies. The ponies are being, dried and then mowed down into a fine dust, and that's a smoke grenade. So, enjoy the fungi extract. Okay, what's gonna happen? Drones are not the issue. They are going to probably go and fix the cyber disks right now, or act stupid, because they want to flank us, but they also want to heal the cyber disk, and they just can't decide. They're like Well, they're women, apparently also. Maybe all the aliens are women. I'm gonna regret that. Not because of the aliens, but I'm gonna regret that. Okay. That's not cool.
All you got.
Okay, so that's a squad side exalt sniper, which is an additional complication in the equation, isn't it? Oh, you didn't! That was a 13% shot! Fucking cunt, it's a good thing it didn't have a laser weapon at least. Okay, just for that one shot, I'm going to destroy the exalt base in January. Okay. And yeah, this guy's running away, he's disabled, so he's not a problem for this turn, but I do have to get rid of one of the cypher discs so that I can keep them both suppressed. There's three of them, and I only have two suppressions. Because somebody hit Lambert! Okay.
Got a lot of heat on me.
Okay, everything is fine.
Got a lot of heat on me.
Mini Pollack doesn't give a fuck. And now we are going to toss down a shredder rocket to captivate the disc and the drone and everybody else and everybody around, cause we ain't got nobody to listen to the shredder rocket. Kaboom! Oh, covering fire, don't hit that! I would be so salty if that shot would hit.
Heavy ordnance confirmed.
Okay, now that makes my life a little easier. Not in the least because Falek's suppression now deals 4 damage, which is fucking awesome. And Paul is gonna take this guy down, hopefully, for me. I don't want to holo target first because, quite frankly, I need that shot to hit before, and Serene has different targets to take care of, and Mini Falek is gonna suppress the big one, so we have to deal with it without the holo.
No ammo.
Oopsie daisy. Yeah, that is shit. Oh no no no, what do I do? What do I do? Well, some brat has to destroy that drone now. And that's the kill cam just showed how much I love the camouflage mode. It's just fucking awesome. Okay, now, so now we are not dealing enough damage to the big disc this turn because we had to use Sombrad's ammo thanks to Zuriel missing the shot. Well, I don't blame you, but if we die, you know who.
No need to ask twice.
Okay, now, do I want an AP grenade? I do, because it's gonna give more damage, but that disc is flying and that something's really wonky with the free aim. I don't really know why, what the hell. But I think I'm gonna have to use an HE grenade. But why? Yeah, we can't really put it there. I would normally be able to bounce it off that beam to the left and... see that? And make it a little better for myself, but with that wonkiness right now, the best thing I can do is to use an HE grenade instead. And at least get rid of that exalt fagot. Because I simply will not be able to bounce the grenade correctly. Now, we have in the zone, so maybe that's gonna make my life better. That's a tough choice, but we do have to start killing, so... Oh, this mother beast.
Target still is empty, can't engage.
All those decisions and all X-ray, for naught. And now we have a very effective suppression that is going to whittle this guy down eventually. If that would be a normal cyber disc, I would just keep suppressing it with Falag until it dies, but this guy has a lot of health, so we are going to run out of ammo before that happens. Now, Bavarian has to get rid of this drone. And that means she has to stay in half cover for now, but next turn she's gonna run full cover and we won't be endangered from the left side. Now we have an 88 with digital, but digital has an arc rifle, so it's not gonna be very effective in any way, so let's just use a pistol and have that shot over.
Explorando.
Me too, no me gusta. No me gusta at all. Okay, drone is droning and healing the cyber dick. What is this? That's another drone. Oh yeah, eat pistol like that. One damage for the win, right? Oh, I wanted to put a rocket there so much, but the single fin can't reach, and Garrett is going to come to the next mission. No, what are you doing, Cyberdisk? Cyberdisk, stop! No! I don't like that seasoning of the Cyberdisk. Holy fuck! I hope Bavarian's okay. And the Seeker is shooting me so bad. Fuck off, Seeker. We have bigger issues. And I don't mean daddy issues, we have cyber issues. Okay, so as it is, I don't really see any glorious options. I'm gonna get ready with the pole to kill that cyber disk. But before anything like this happens, we must deal as much damage to it as possible, so it doesn't do anything stupid.
It's killing time.
This really poops in my bottle right now. Okay, someone has to deal damage to the big one. Bavarian has to run away, but can't. Mini Falek is unfortunately very busy. Nitmar. Let's start to get rid of those drones, because otherwise we will start being annoying, healing the damage we deal. We can't have that now, can we?
Taken care of. Negative, weapons dry. Ready.
Don't worry
rock.
About it. Okay, now... Why not Marek can't shoot anymore? Well, apparently not. Okay, that's fine. Zuriel is gonna shoot the big disc. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to save Bavarian with a gold grenade, because I simply don't have any other choice. And even though it opens me to be grenaded by the cyber dick on the left, I do not have
yes,
a choice. So, yeah. That's what's gonna happen. What do we do in the meantime? We have a good chance of hitting that cyber disk, but alloy cannon is not the best weapon to do that with. And Paul, hello, don't reload. Come on, Paul.
In marcha.
I mean, digital damage. Come on, make it work. There we go. Meh. Okay, and single fin's going to taunt that cyber disk. It's a little known fact, but cyber disk very often shoot the last person that shot at them, even if it is not the best thing to do. It's not something I would count on happening, but I do not really have any other
defensive
options right now, because that's... This is the only option I have. We must count that the cyber disk is gonna shoot single thing enemies. Other than that, it can go for a flank, it can shoot us. If it goes for a flank, I hope it's going to shoot the mech. If it tosses a grenade, I didn't.
Incoming fire!
Well, damn. That was lucky. That was literally like 1 in 3 chance of that happening. Okay. Now the big dick is overwatching, so we are not worried about it. Now we may start taking care of the exact goons, because their goons
nobody loves them. They have no families.
He's down.
And we killed one so that his blood splattered all over his head. We are starting to run out of ammo, so soon somebody is gonna have to take the pleasure of suppressing the big disc. I don't know if it is going to be equally effective, but we have no other choice, so fuck it. In the meantime, Sombrand can just... We can keep this guy suppressed until he dies, that's not a problem. Actually, we may just as well be able to kill it next turn. I don't want to take that shot. Fire. That's a miss, too bad. What the hell? Stop panicking, you just missed a shot. She just yelled, help, somebody help me, help! Okay, Paul is going to finish off the cyber disk for me. Or not. Well, Bavarian can do what I want damage, right? Yep. Boom. And that's what we call vengeance. Now, we can disable the big disk. Which is probably what I should do, but I'm not gonna. Pressed, so I don't think he's going to be trying anything funny. And we can disable it next turn so that Falek can reload or shoot. That way Sombrad will be able to actually open fire at it and finish it off if Falek fails. It's overwatching as predicted. And that means I'm gonna give Nidmare the pleasure of finishing it off. You don't wanna, guns okay. Dry. Well, Mini Falek can take care of it, 69.
I'm all out. I'll get it next time.
Yeah, you're not going to get it next time. You had your chance. Now fuck off, Falek. Let other people do some killing. And Paul may finish off the Exalti. There you go. Boop. That pretty much finishes that encounter. Except Sombrad's going to actually pull the last trigger.
Gonna need to reload
and that's
soon.
About it.
We're green to go.
Okay,
so yeah, now we are going to reload, get some health, and everything's gonna be fine.
I'm on it.
Don't you worry about a thing. Ping, ping. Don't you worry about a thing.
Estoy preparado.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Reload complete.
We are going to be reloading and moving on. We hear some floaters ahead.
Reloaded!
And now we are about ready-ish. I'm gonna get people and assemble them on the hill in the middle. I don't really expect any danger or trouble to happen. Because, well, we're gonna be fine.
C'est parti.
We've dealt with all the enemies, right?
I'm on my way.
As you see, we are dealing with the maintenance. It's going to take a lot of time, because that's what it usually happens, especially when you have to heal some people. Okay, I'm gonna get digital dude a little closer.
Yes,
the medkit. I should have get closer one more tile. That would allow me to use the psi healing. Mana is whatever.
Co tam za zvuk?
Yeah, so we hear the enemies ahead. My opposition right now is probably going to be floaters because we hear them an awful lot, so
double time.
That's what I think is going to be ahead of us. Gonna jump down and run because there is no time. I don't want this mission to last 50 hours. Holy fuck, there is one more Exalt still alive. Whoopsie daisy. Well, I'm gonna just have Mini Falek take care of it. 99. Rapid fire should do it.
He's
and that's
down.
Why we love LMG. And now we can continue with our merry way. Because why the hell not? Come on, Serin.
Solutions.
You can almost get to the other side, but let's not be hasty. Half move. Fuck me. And I almost dashed my tiny life. Okay. It's a good thing I have a battle scanner aplenty. So we can just find him and give Netmare the pleasure of finishing that little piece of treacherous scum off.
Boom. See ya in hell.
See ya in hell.
Got it covered.
Okay, yeah, so now I'm going to just basically keep reloading moving forward.
So
I use the medkit. And we are going to set up in the halfway before we move to stage of the operation. This is one of the longest missions ever, but yeah, 3 days later, boom, there we go.
Heading to that location.
And I have a faster internet, but I still don't want
new target acquired.
Oh crap. Yeah, but I still don't want to keep too many kilometers of footage where nothing is happening in this mission, right? So I just skipped ahead that 15 minutes maybe. And now we see additional pod. We have mectoids, 2 mutants. I am going to do the best I can to stop them. I'm not entirely prepared because we are in the midway. But I can certainly deal some damage and do some sort of stopping to them. Actually quite a plenty. I'm gonna use Netmare to deal as much damage as possible to the mectoid. Boom. Boom. This mission may actually... This fight may actually end in a captive. It's a good situation to care for creme grenading and suppressions and stuff. Bavaria's gonna be in the back. Now Paul... Mectoid is your prey. Too bad we didn't have a railgun, eh? But it's broken!
Już tam idę.
So we don't have it. This guy is gonna be captured, or this one, or his elite friend, but either way they are both going to be stopped. By a chem grenade, because I don't want to be hit with the alien grenade. Okay, Palek needs to get ready to use command. I think Digidude's gonna be, if possible, mind fraying. I should have disabled actually. All the same, because mind fray worked, but just for the note, the disable shot would be a much safer option right now, however, not lasting as long as the mind fray.
Aye, aye, Commander.
But the long lasting effect is not what we are looking for in here, because the creature is gonna be dead next turn. So a disable shot would be completely sufficient and I suck. Luckily for me that 41% worked, because the disable shot would be at least an 80 if not better. So I will spit in my beard for
I'm
that.
On the move.
And that makes it not even gonna leave the neck to the next turn. Actually fuck it. I'm gonna get Sombrad into a better position to fight and command him to get working on, there we go, suppression. Because we are flanking one guy and they are camped, but the mutant elite is a mutant elite. He's gonna run away, but the former mutant is totally able to throw a suicidal grenade or do something stupid, so I'm gonna have it suppressed since it is not flanked. That way all the enemies are being disabled. Mutant Elite is gonna run away, take damage from the chem grenade. Mectoid is going to shoot with mind fray, so screw him. And the normal mutant is gonna get
dead. Fire over
like
there.
So. That way they are all safe. And that's a 23.
Got a lot of heat on
me. That Mectoid had a lot of aim. Well, not gonna help him much anymore. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Another victim of Netmare's thirst for blood and marshmallows. Now we are going to reload and hit the elite in the back. Boop. And now we are going to try and capture it. Because why the hell not? Come on. There we go. Boop, boop.
Smash Ignio!
Well, fuck you too, Elite. I have another arc thrower, so...
Light him up!
Boop.
Not so tough now, are ya?
Yeah, not so tough now, hey? Okay, now we don't really have to worry. The normal mutants gonna die.
No rounds.
Or the elite. It is being suppressed in case, so not gonna do anything silly. And I'm gonna try to kill it because we want to bring some Meridian commanders with me.
Negative damage.
We have been seeing them for a while and I don't even have them interrogated. So we are going to try and bring our Meridian commanders. I know there's going to be at least one, because we heard the sectoids and on a basic assault mission, there is no way. Yeah, how about I follow target it first, eh?
Yeah.
My bad. Good? Good?
On the move.
I'm not a smart man. But in any way, we are going to solve the problem next turn. As you saw, it had 1% chance to hit.
Voy hacia ese lugar.
So it is absolutely the whateverator, and I'm going to even try to disable it, because why the hell not? Now you can't even shoot it. That disable was just an icing on the cake. I just did it for shits and giggles. We aren't going to need it in the next two turns, since it's the end of the room and that's the last pod in here. I'm absolutely sure of that, almost. There is only like three tiles we don't see, so screw it. Now it decided to hunker down.
Come on. Okay.
I'm still gonna hit it. It can't shoot me back, so I'm going to maybe come closer and kick it in the face. Or wedge it. Or tell him jokes about blondes. My wife just showed me a finger.
Firing incendiary.
I knew I'm gonna get the wedge. Okay, so now we can't really do anything to this guy, so how about we just get into position? Actually, need Mara can deal some serious damage if she hits. But yeah, this guy is disabled, so there is no real need to worry about him.
Let's do this!
And thus I shan't. I'm going to just get my weapon studied, reloaded,
back online.
And everything's gonna be fine. Even if it keeps hunkering down right
moving
now,
out.
I will kill it. I can probably break it anyway, but why bother?
Bring in the
pain. I'll have a double suppression just in case it tries to run. Might be fun. I don't know why I hunkered Valerian, because she's wounded really. That thing can't shoot her. Now it's going to get die miserably killed by double suppressions. Just watch it. Watch it. You can't run when machine gun fire chops off your legs. Oh.
Hostile eliminated.
Well, that's sort of a wedgie. That's Xcom wedgie. Anyway, I will see you at the gate when we get ready to the next stage of the operation.